Good morning, students. Today we are going to conduct that experiment number 8, the study of open and short circuit of simple circuit. To perform this experiment, let us look at the aim. The aim is to study the effects of open and short circuit of simple circuit. The apparatus required to conduct this experiment, that is, one regulated power supply whose rating like 0 to 30 volts and decay resistance box resistors of 10 ohms, multimeter, an ammeter of 0 to 5 amperes of current rating. Then look at the following circuit diagram. If you look at this is the following circuit diagram, this is that a DC voltage source having the polarities positive and negative. If there is no any this short circuit path at here, then current will flow from positive terminal to the bulb and again the current will come to the negative polarity of this DC voltage source. Then during this interval there exists a short circuit via load. Once there exists a short circuit via load, then the voltage is maximum and current is like whatever the current which is flowing through this bulb that it will display. But if you are going to make one short circuit path at here, by that time there is no any flow of current through the bulb. All current will flow through the short circuit path because always current chooses the short circuit path. So instead of flowing through this filament of this incandescent bulb, it has some resistance. So instead of flowing that resistance, the majority of current, all the current, total current will flow through this short circuit path which is in parallel to this incandescent bulb. So at this condition, that is a dead short circuit condition, voltage is zero and current is infinity. Next, look at this following circuit diagram. This is nothing but a closed circuit diagram where a DC voltage source is connected with a incandescent lamp. During that interval, the current flows from higher potential terminal, that is positive terminal, to negative terminal via bulb. So this is nothing but a closed circuit where a short circuit happened via incandescent bulb. During this condition, voltage is the applied voltage and the current is the current which is flowing through this bulb. Then one more circuit called as open circuit. If you look at this open circuit, there is a DC voltage source having the polarities positive and negative, and here the conductor was broken and the switch is here open circuit condition. During open circuit condition, there is no any flow of current which is flowing through this bulb, hence the condition of the bulb is not glowing. The condition of the bulb is off because the circuit is in open circuit condition. During open circuit condition, the current is equal to zero and the voltage is equal to maximum. To perform this experiment, look at the procedure. The procedure consists of connections are made as per the circuit diagram. Switch on the DC power supply. Initially the switch will be closed. Measure the voltage and current. Open the switch. Again measure the voltage and current. To perform this experiment live, so look at the following video.
Today we are conducting an experiment on study of effect of open circuit and short circuit in simple circuits. To conduct this experiment, we need the following apparatus. So, apparatus required to conduct this experiment like RPS and the connecting wires and one LED bulb. So, here I am switching on the power supply and here I set that amplitude like 2 volts. For suppose if I set a voltage like 2 volts here, now one wire I connected to that higher potential terminal and another wire I am connected to that lower potential terminal. When these two wires are not yet short circuited to any bulb or any load, then the circuit is open circuit condition. So look at the open circuit condition here. This is the open circuit condition here. The RPS, that is the voltage source, where we can vary that 0 to 30 volts, and here the switch is open. During the switch is open, the current is 0 and the condition for the lamp LED, it is off position. In off position and the switch is open circuit condition, the voltage is 2 volts and current is 0 amperes. That we can verify here through this RPS. Here the voltage is 2 volts and the current is 0 amperes and the wires are in open circuit condition. Next. Again, we are going to conduct one more experiment, that is, look at this figure. In this figure, I am closing the switch, SW is closed. When switch is closed, by the time, this RPS, that is voltage source, and the conducting wires, and LED lamp, all are short circuited and it is formed a single loop. Once the single loop has been formed, during that interval, here under short circuit condition with LED lamp, the supply voltage. Look at here, the supply voltage now I set for 2 volts by varying that course knob. Now I am going to make a short circuit this LED lamp, and LED lamp is glowing. When lamp is glowing, by that time the supply voltage is 2 volts and the current is like 0.01 amperes. So now we are going to tabulate that supply voltage is 2 volts and the current is like 0.01 amperes. And again we are going to extend the same experiment by making that another circuit where, look at this circuit. In this circuit, if you see that here there is a RPS where we are connected one voltage source whose reading is like 0 to 30 volts and it is connected to that one LED lamp through conducting wires. So by the time current is flowing actually through the bulb, and we see that the current is like 0.01 amperes in the previous case. Now I am going to make a short circuit across to this LED lamp. By that interval, the total current which is delivered by this voltage source is flowing through this short circuit condition, and there is no any current which is flowing through this LED lamp. So this and all we are going to check practically, then come to the circuit diagram. Yes, look at here. When we switch on the power supply, when we set the voltage like 2 volts, now LED lamp is glowing. When LED lamp is glowing, by that time here we are seeing that the voltage is 2 volts and the current flowing through LED lamp is 0.01 amperes. This is a short circuit which is happened via load. Now I am going to make a dead short circuit with help of an extra wire which is going to connect across the lamp. When I am going to connect this extra wire across the lamp, during that interval, the condition of the lamp is off and dead short circuit fault happened. During dead short circuit condition, if you see here, voltage is 0 and current is 0.32 amperes. The current is very very high current during dead short circuit condition. Here we can notify that current and voltage. So finally during dead short circuit condition the voltage is 0 and the current is 0.32 amperes and the lamp is in off position. This and all here we are going to tabulate. Here the voltage is during dead short circuit condition, voltage is 0 volts and current is like 0.032 amperes. The current is very very high during dead short circuit condition among the three cases, because this is the case where we are doing that experiment under dead short circuit condition where the current is like 0.032 amperes and the voltage is 0. In previous case, here during open circuit condition the current is like 0 amperes. During short circuit condition with load, that means LED lamp, the current is like 0.01 amperes. Hence here we are compare the three cases. On the three cases, during open circuit condition current is 0, during short circuit condition with load the current is like 0.01 amperes, during dead short circuit condition the current is very very high, that is 0.032 amperes. This and all here we are compared in this experiment. Thank you.